Hello everyone and welcome to IT Chit Chat. Today we are going to do a budget-friendly DIY. I have taken an unused frying pan which I was planning to trash, but now we will give it a new look. Let's clean the pan thoroughly and wipe it. You can also smoothen it with a sandpaper to remove rough surfaces. I've taken a brush and acrylic paint, which is white in color. You can also use gesso. Acrylic paint would be more of a budget-friendly option than gesso. We will be using white color as a base, and now we will paint the pan completely inside out. Meanwhile, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do not forget to subscribe and share this channel with your friends and family. We are hoping to upload new contents every Sunday. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram with the handle IT Chit Chat. If you feel that the brush is getting dry, you can use just a few drops of water, but not too much. To avoid the strokes of the paintbrush being visible, let's dab the entire surface with a sponge or a dabber, and then let's dry it for around 2 to 3 hours. I've taken decoupage paper, which is readily available online or at craft stores. We can also use newspapers or magazine cuttings if you don't have decoupage paper. They are all budget-friendly options. I'm planning to keep the theme as kitchen and nature, so I've selected the papers accordingly. The pan is dry and now it's time for us to decide on which paper cutting goes where. It's up to you to arrange it the way you would want it to be. We'll use water to soften the decoupage paper and then we'll tear off the edges. It is going to be really imperfect. We really don't want any perfect cuttings or designs. So this is how we'll be doing it. I've just dabbed a few drops of water around the edges, and then once it gets softened, we'll just go ahead and tear it off. You can do the same thing for the magazines or newspaper cuttings if you're doing that. There is no problem to do that in any of those papers, but we just have to make sure that we're using papers which are not too thick. That's it. I've taken a paper cutting of a coat which I liked, Cooking with Love, and then I've just painted it with black. That is also something that I would be sticking onto this frying pan. Now we've arranged all the decoupage papers and the coat here, and now it's time for us to glue it. I've used the decoupage glue. We can also use Fevicol. Fevicol is going to be the budget-friendly option for us. Now, once that is done, we will just go ahead and start sticking each of those papers onto the frying pan. Once you've stuck it, you can always go ahead and coat it with the glue on the top as well. We'll stick all the cut pieces to the frying pan just like this. Just make sure that you reconfirm that all of them are stuck properly. If you see that any edges are coming out, you can always put the glue on top of it and it'll get stuck properly. I've taken a jute rope now to cover the handle of the frying pan. You can keep it as it is, but just to give it a little bit of aesthetics, we will be covering the handle with this jute rope. We'll apply the glue over the handle, and then once that is done, we'll stick the rope around the handle. Once this is done, you can dry it for around 1 or 2 hours so that it gets dried up completely, including the pan as well as the handle. And you can just use it as it is. But if you would want to give it more color or give it a little bit of colored punch, then you can go ahead and paint it. I wanted to give it a little bit of colorful punch because my kitchen is kind of pale. So now I would be painting it using watercolor. I'm just highlighting all those cups and saucers or the body of the birds, etc., using the watercolor. I would also be coloring it using the watercolor for the background. I really wanted to keep it white, but I wanted to try out a couple of different colors, and that's what I have been doing. I don't know. In the end, I felt that I should have kept it white because I love the color white, but let's see. This is the first one, so mistakes always do happen. But you can always let me know if you like the white background better or did you like this one. I'm planning to give a bit of antique look to it, so I've taken golden glitters and given it a couple of beads here and there on the cups as well as on the flowers. Now I've taken golden color acrylic paint and we will paint on the edges all around the circumference so that we give it a royal look. Our unused frying pan with the new look is almost ready. You can always protect it from dust and pollution using varnish. I've used gloss varnish. You can avoid the step entirely as well. I hope you guys like this video. Please do not forget to subscribe, share, and comment with your feedbacks. See you soon in the next video.